Hello, welcome to Live in the Studio with the Gentle Roller, episode 2. Today I'm going to be showing you how to work a vest using two drive rollers. I'm going to lay up a front and a back and then utilize two drive rollers so that I can roll both sides at the same time. So unluckily for me, I'm not going to get a chance to read during this project. I'm lucky enough to have two super soft drive rollers because Philip produces them. So I don't expect most of you to have two super soft drive rollers. So I'm going to show you how to turn your hard drive roller into a super soft by wrapping bubble wrap around it. Okay, Philip tells me that what I've just done is a helix tie. It's pretty nifty and it will stop the bubble wrap from moving around. Philip's pointed out how I've done it wrong one end and right the other end because he intervened halfway through and showed me how to do it properly. But anyway, I'm going to push on with this. Half right, half wrong, meant to do a super soft drive roller. Okay, for this project I'm doing a simple uni-felted vest or tunic. I'm not sure at this stage whether I'm going to have a full one-piece front or whether I might decide to cut it down the centre after that pre-felt. So I'm starting off with the one-piece. I don't use a template when I'm making a garment. What I tend to do is my pieces are fairly square. I just fold it over, get a centre point, and I cut out a neck hole and an arm hole. And I've done that with both sides, making the front a bit deeper than the back. I've actually used the whole width of the sari, cutting off the selvages. So the whole width of the sari has become the length of my vest. If this doesn't felt quickly, I'll be very surprised. This fabric is very soft and there are areas in it where it's sort of thinner and the fibres and the threads seem to have pulled, so it's just a band of a different colour. So it might be a nice nuance when it's felted, or it may not show up at all. So it's very thin. Perfect for felting. Anyway, so I'll be using Sari. Some superfine Merino and some silk hankies. I like using silk hankies because you can shape them. You can use them really fine or thin. I find that they add wonderful texture and they felt really nice, really beautifully. So, simple materials, very straightforward vest. I'm going to be using some new plastic to sandwich my materials in today, mainly because I tend to reuse my plastic and I didn't want to cut down my bigger pieces, so as I'll be working smaller pieces today. So, and this is just cheap painter's drop sheet. It's not the cheapest because the cheapest tends to be like glad wrap, and after one use you have to throw it out, and I don't like to waste the plastic too much. It's got a bit of crunchiness to it. I expect it to last for several projects. Okay, that big rope was about 100 grams, so I've just split it in half, but it's manageable when I'm laying up. And then I'm going to take one piece of rope, I'm going to split it, and I'll split it again. I might even split it again. When I work, cut off working in the middle sections, and that's what I'm going to do. So I'm just pulling one layer in multi directions. Always go back. So it's very fast, one layer,